And now that we have a better handle on what these selections actually represent, let's go back to our circles, get the exit selection on it, again, which corresponds to every circle except year 1930, and call the D3 function remove. So this has the effect of finding every element on the page through the exit selection that doesn't belong there and simply removing them. If we run this code and look at our map, how it's been updated, it's hard to see since the attendance was so small, but there's a single dot remaining here. I'll try to zoom in. And you can see here, it corresponds to the 1930 games. So our exit and remove have worked correctly. Going back to our text editor, now that we've removed every element that doesn't belong there, let us add or update any element that should change on the page. As you can see here, much of the code is identical to the code that drew our initial circles. And this is very intentional because we want all the circles representing the attendance of games to look similarly. As you can see here, for the circles, new data bound, which is all the circles on the page, bound to new data filtered on our key function, we take the enter selection. So anything that's not currently on the page, we want to append a circle to the page and then set all of the same properties. Notice here that I didn't include any of the calls to dot style, and I've abstracted all the styles of circles up into CSS in the head of the page. Rather than duplicate a lot of the same code to change the styling on the circles as well, it's cleaner and easier if we're going to be adding and removing a bunch of circles on the page to not have to specify every time that we want the same styles that every other circle had. So now let's put all the code together that we've both run in the console and that I've shown here to first remove the circles that don't belong there and then add any circles that need to be there. As you can see here, we're simply removing any circles in the exit selection and appending any circles in the enter selection. Let's go back to our console and just test that the circle adding and removing works as we expect. And here we've stopped right before we call the update function. So let's see what happens if we call update with the year 1930. As expected, every circle disappeared except for the tiny, tiny circle representing the year 1930. Let's try to show the most recent World Cup in Brazil, passing update of 2014. As you can see here, the 1930 World Cup was removed, and we've added the Brazil World Cup. So it appears that our update function is working correctly. Given what I've shown you, what do you think happens if we try to update a year in which there were no World Cup? For example, the year 1969.